conversation. It's the hardest thing for me to do. And
so, it's the most important part that I just heard that Saki Abe is retiring in August. Remember her?
Yeah.
You did a lot of matches with her and JD, right? How does that make you feel when somebody is retiring after so many years?
Yeah, you know, many people quit, of course.
Yes.
You know, I will quit one day too.
Really?
Right?
I hope not.
Everybody does. I mean, like...
Jaguar is still wrestling.
Yeah, no.
She's my 50, trainer. 52. She's your trainer, right?
I respect her a lot.
You have 10 more years.
Yeah, she's great. So.
She is great. And so are you. Anyway, how does that make you feel when, like, somebody... You were young, you were wrestling her, and now, after many years...
I have many memories.
Mm-hmm.
With her?
Like a cage match when you were both on top of the cage?
Yeah, I saw her many times.
Mm-hmm.
So I, you know, many memories.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, like, it's not just her, many people.
Right.
Somebody quit, you know, like, retired.
Yeah.
You know, like, life is just one time.
Right.
So if they find something, it's very good, I think. You know, like, I mean, I do like mixed martial arts. I really like it. So I do like, you know, like everything I like it. So life is just one time. So maybe Abe-san find something, you know, like she wanna do.
Right.
So
right.
I think I'm very happy for her. And and maybe she will get married. She will be happy. Or, I miss her. I mean, I miss many people.
Yeah.
But I decided I will wrestle here, and I will live here, you know, like...
Yeah.
So.
Can you tell me that story, like how you thought you wanted to wrestle in the USA? Huh? Why did you decide you wanted to wrestle in the USA?
I mean, when I came here, wrestling is a very different.
Right.
So...
In Japan and in USA?
Yeah, it's so different.
How would you explain it? What's the difference?
I mean, I wrestled people, I think, how different?
How, yeah.
So different.
Because I've seen wrestling in Japan and I've seen wrestling here, and I agree with you, it's different.
I mean, wrestling, I can't do by myself, you know? I needed someone will wrestle.
To,
yeah. Yeah, like with someone.
Right.
So. It's kind of life too.
Yeah.
I can't live by myself. Always like friend, family, is many people.
Right.
So it's same, like, you know, like so different. So how different?
Because I read somewhere that you liked the wrestling in the USA and you wanted to come here.
I mean, like, you know, like Japanese people, when you went to Japan, they sit down to watch match.
Very quiet.
So quiet.
Respectful.
Yeah. Respectful, maybe, but you know, like more people are like watching. But you know, like they want to maybe cheer. Maybe they are happy.
Yeah.
It's kind of Japanese people will hiding to, you know, feel.
Yeah.
So like when I came here, I really like it. I could feel, I could make people happy. So like I couldn't speak any English when I came here, but like I could do something to make happy for people. So I mean that time I couldn't speak any English then, but many like American friend helped me. So then I was like JD. So you know, like JD office, people helped me. So I don't have to worry what time I have to be show or something. Like office will book me as a show and you know, like set up everything, you know. I just will go there to make ring with them, you know, something, then with the show. Then it's so different. I came here kind of like I respect everybody here because they have to do it by themselves, you know. It's so difficult, but it's kind of this country, if you wanna be a wrestler, people will pay for wrestling school to become a wrestler. But we are different, you know, like Japan.
In Japan, there's a dojo system.
We have like a test, you know, like how many we can do push-up, So sometimes people fail, so can't be wrestler, you know? Like, have to be more trainee, so we have to pass this to be dojo student, you know?
Yes,
like dojo student. So we want to call pro wrestler, then we have professional test too.
Yes.
So we do professional test, then we pass, we became pro wrestler. It's
and
very different, you know?
In the U.S., it's a little more democratic. Anybody that's passionate, it doesn't matter what your body type or anything, you can, as long as you can pay to go to school.
Yeah,
and
I mean, like, don't have to do 1,000 squat, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
But, like, you know, like, when I went to WWE, I didn't know WWE because I was not a pro wrestling fan before the pro wrestler. So, like, you know, like, very... so different, you know, like girls can make sexy, you know. I think it's very good, you know. It's so different, you know. Japanese pro wrestling, and I don't know, I should not say or no. I went to WWE before, please don't tell
yeah,
this one.
Yeah.
Like, one guy say, like, oh, you should learn from Sumi, like, Sumi is from Japan, you should see, like, Sumi, do you have something, DVD or video for her? She said, no, the Japanese pro wrestler, I mean, woman's wrestler is just fat. She said that.
Just what?
Just fat.
She said you were too fat?
No.
Oh.
Japanese pro wrestler, you know, woman's pro wrestler.
Yeah.
They said they're just fat.
Unbelievable. But that tells you something about...
I mean, you know, like, but maybe she doesn't know pro wrestling. That's why
she it's about image,
see,
it's about,
you know, you know, should be WWE, have to be, you know, something sexy, but I really respect that. But, you know, she got the fire quick. So.
Right.
WWE.
Right.
So,
well, you know.
Yeah, like.
You preferred the wrestling here and the life here, the culture in America. You
so
just
different.
Feel comfortable here.
Yeah, it's I mean, like, you know, like my life. If I'm anywhere, like in Japan or America, always challenge. You know, like have to be challenged by myself.
Mm-hmm.
So
you,
I mean, like, I can live, I think, anywhere. You know, like I'm kind of. I can eat anything. I'm not picky. I can eat anything. So.
What do you miss most about Japanese life, family?
Yeah.
Not even so much the food. You can get similar food here.
You know, like, kind of, I live in New Jersey.
Yeah.
So I can.
You can get a lot of
I
good
mean, like,
Japanese food.
I'm not
food.
Really like, oh, I miss Japanese food. Or
yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I don't have a feel.
Yeah.
I'm more.
If
like,
you ate at KFC tonight, you don't miss it that much, right?
I mean, like, when I was in Japan, I always ate KFC too.
Right.
Kind of at my house, alone, we don't have KFC. So I found the KFC. I said, oh, lucky.
Now, why did you decide to get into MMA? And how many years ago was that?
It's like 8 years ago.
8 years ago.
I really need.
Was it a new challenge that you were after?
No, I needed the money.
Okay.
So,
yeah.
It's funny, like I have an international bank card.
Yeah.
But I lost. So then I lost. Whenever I lost, I have to go back to Japan. But I don't have money, so I can't go back there.
Right.
I didn't want to ask my parents, you know,
right.
family.
Right.
So I decided to. My friend asked me, "You wanna fight?" I said, "When?" He said, "It's 10 days later."
Wow.
I never training MMA.
Wow.
You know, but he said, like, "But you can get the money. If you got you won, you can get the double." I said, "Okay, let's go." Then I training 10 days. So that time, I was like 124 pounds.
Wow.
Then I have to be like 112 pounds.
112?
12.
Wow.
So I have to lose 12 pounds, and
wow.
It was very tough. So funny thing is, I went to fight there. I did, you know, weigh in. So my weight was like 0.5 pounds over. So, but it was like, I think long, because they did a carpet to, you know, like.
Yeah.
I know, I checked weight before, like, you know, like very big. So I cut my hair. I got so mad. I said, okay, I will cut my hair. But it didn't change, so it didn't help.
Oh, too bad.
So then
too
after bad. I did a jump rope and something.
Yeah.
It's so funny.
Yeah.
So after, like, weighing, okay, I didn't have money. I couldn't eat.
Wow.
Is it true?
Wow.
You know, like that time I didn't have money. I mean, I lost the banker, that's why.
Yeah.
I decided
yeah.
to, I need money, I will find.
Right.
So
wow.
then when I start, I really like it. Training with her, I did judo a long time.
You did judo when you were a teenager, right?
When I was like 8 years old.
Right, yeah.
25, like yeah. 70 yeah. years. So after.
And Megumi did also, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
she kind of. You were both in judo before you came to pro wrestling. She came first, and then you came after her?
We started the same day.
Oh, wow, wow.
I mean, we are same judo team, then yeah. we became pro wrestling.
Okay.
She passed this the first.
Yeah. yeah. Cool,
yeah.
cool. That's amazing. Well, I know when you first came to the States, you were feuding with... Mercedes Martinez.
Yeah, yeah.
And when I first met you, it was at an NYWC show on
yeah,
Long Island in February of 2010.
Yeah.
And you came out and wrestled Mercedes that night. And tell me why you like wrestling her. Why
I
she's
like
special.
I mean, when I came here in 2002, I wrestled her many times.
In the Boston area,
that, yeah,
right?
Yeah, that time around there. Me, her, April.
Mm-hmm.
I have to go.
Do you have to go? Okay.
Yes.
Say bye.
Bye.
You know I'm bad at communication. It's the hardest thing for me to do. And it's the most important part that relationships will go through. And I give it up. That but I know that you're gonna be okay anyway. You know there's no rhyme or reason for the way you turned out to be. I didn't go and try to change my mind, not intentionally. I know it's hard to hear me say it, but I can't bear to stay. And I just know that you're gonna be okay anyway. Always keep your heart light.